Just a few weeks, the city will have a new mayor for the first time in almost 30 years, as Jim Brainard is finally stepping down after leading Carmel through a period of unprecedented change and a lot of roundabouts, too.
Our Bob Donaldson from our partner station CBS4 recently sat down with him. They talk about those roundabouts, development, and what's next for the city he led for so long.
Carmel's on good, solid footing.
How long has Jim Brainard been mayor of Carmel? The last time he wasn't, O.J. Simpson had just been acquitted. Michael Jordan had just returned to the Bulls. ER was the top TV show. And Windows 95 had just been launched.
Carmel's a thriving city. We accomplished everything we set out to do in this city and more. And I thought, you know, now's a good time.
It's been a pleasure.
Brainard will leave office this month after 28 years.
Go.
And after transforming Carmel from a small bedroom community into a thriving small city that just recently was profiled by the Wall Street Journal as one of the best places to live in the country.
We have to build a place that the best and brightest are willing to spend their lives in, raise their families in, and build their businesses in. This yearning for a traditional downtown.
It's hard to dispute how much Carmel has changed under Brainard. Just drive around and around and around. The city has become known as the roundabout capital of the country, with 151 of them and counting. Brainard says they move traffic, they're better for the environment, but mostly, he says they're just safer.
Our personal injury accidents and all accidents also decline. It's all about speed. Human error rates never going to change, but at slower speeds, we have more response time, and the accidents are so much less severe.
Mean, nasty comments.
Brainard's tenure was not without controversy, and he's not without his critics. Carmel's bond rating was downgraded under the weight of all the debt from all the projects he's championed. But the mayor claims many of his ideas have paid off, both figuratively and literally.
I've had a lot of people come up to me and say, you know, I wasn't for this or that 20 years ago, but I love it now.
Brainard leaves office as one of his highest profile ideas thrives. The Carmel Kris Kringle Market now attracts more people every year than the Indy 500.
So the last two buildings in the Carmel City Center.
And right next door, one of the final pieces of Carmel's ongoing downtown development takes shape. Something that started as Brainard began his tenure.
This is the sort of place where people from all these different backgrounds that make up our country have an opportunity to get to know each other, get to know people that have very different backgrounds than they have. And when you're just starting to have subdivisions and barely know the people across the street, that sort of interaction isn't happening.
But for many, Carmel still struggles with its reputation as an expensive, exclusive enclave that's not welcoming to all Hoosiers.
It has to be a balance.
Brainard contends the city has become more diverse and inclusive in his 28 years, progress that he says is also key to Carmel's future.
You can't have a great city unless everybody from every background feels welcome and included. And that's one of the things we worked very hard on in Carmel.
Meantime, check this out. There's a brand new t-shirt paying homage to Mayor Brainard's legacy in the community. The shirt is being sold by the store known as All Things Carmel. It features the mayor's likeness along with images of a roundabout, the Palladium, the Monon Greenway, and Kris Kringle Market.
And our partners over at CBS4 will interview Mayor Brainard's successor, Sue Finkham. That'll happen at Kris Kringle Market tomorrow.
Yeah. By the way, one question Mayor Brainard wouldn't answer is what's next for him personally. He says he'll reveal that here in the months ahead.
Well, still ahead.